It has been known for years that music affects our brains and bodies, emotionally and physically. And science can also explain those reactions, as we learned from our first speaker of tonight, Ilse Smolders. But science can also be incorporated into music. Mathematician and philosopher Jean-Paul van Bendegem will take us on a scientific and musical journey, proving the theorem of Pythagoras. You might still remember that from secondary school. It's my honor to introduce my previous professor, Jean-Paul van Bendegem.
Hey, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'm going to perform a short piece entitled Proving Pythagoras' Theorem. It's unfortunately a piece of contemporary music, so it should be rather irritating and annoying, but that's the beauty of it. But on the happy side, it is short. One. E-I. Two. V-A. There's an echo in the room. Three. O-I. Four. U-I. U-I. K-I-E. Six. P-Q-A. Seven. P, Q, E. Eight. Nine. Ten. Yes. Yes. That's the standard applause for contemporary music. You might be wondering what this is all about. Well, in fact, you have been listening to a proof of the theorem of Pythagoras. As you all know, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. You have actually listened to the proof itself. Now, you wonder, how? How did I do this? Well, actually, a mathematical proof, one of the typical properties of a mathematical proof is that it is highly stylized. So you can really reduce it to the essential elements. So for instance, given is a square of side C, you add four right angle triangles, you go on, you have a very limited vocabulary. Now you can simply make an inventory of the vocabulary, and then you can take a highly simplistic code, which is what I have done. So for instance, the word given, something is given in a proof, you start by given so and so. Given in this case was, and as you have heard, the steps were numbered from 1 to 11. They simply correspond to the 11 steps in the proof. So what you heard me playing in the beginning was this. Given, right? I equal to C. That's basically it. It becomes a bit confusing because A, B, C in A square plus B square equals C square. A is a C, B is an E, and C is a G. But apart from that, there's no problem. So this is A, this is B, this is C. To add something is this. Being equal is this. And squared is this. So I'll just take the 11th line, the line of the piece, which went as follows. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. One last time without comment. You have to agree that you have never enjoyed mathematics so much. Thank you.